performing an EKG or an ECG, which is an electrocardiograph, this we're going to use clips that we can clamp on the arms and legs, and this is going to measure the electrical activity in the heart. So for a stable patient, it's ideal if they can be lying in a right lateral recumbency. On the right side. If the patient's not stable, you can just do it standing. But we're going to do this with minimal stress to the patient at all times, making sure that they're not in any respiratory distress or cardiac distress. I'm going to make sure that her limbs are perpendicular to the body when I put in on the leads, and not touching each other also. So I've got my leads. I've got a white lead, a black lead, and a red lead. The white lead is going to go on the right arm or foreleg. That's on the downside. Clipping it to the skin, kind of behind the elbow. The black lead is going to go on the left arm, clipping onto the skin behind the elbow. And then the red lead is going to go on the left leg. And once my leads are all in place, I'm going to use alcohol just as a conductor. Just put a little bit on each lead for some kind of an ultrasonic gel that will conduct the electrical activity. Okay, I'm going to use a minute to register on my machine.
Yeah, and we were right on.
So that's showing up on my monitor and giving me an accurate representation of the electrical waves in the heart. You're watching on this EKG for anything abnormal, any sudden jerks. So we're getting a few dips right here, but that when watching the patient is because the patient's moving a little bit and not completely still. So now she's holding still and her feet are perpendicular to the body, not touching each other. We're back to a normal rhythm. No abnormal beats in the heart. Okay, so that would be a productive EKG. Many different models that we can save that wave into the file. And then that's performing an EKG on a dog.